last game and possibly you can say the biggest game, but it hasn't hit me yet. I'm still yet to understand that, you know, this maximum I have two innings in my life.
Left.
Maximum.
Left.
Yes. So I'm yet to come to terms with that. But maybe once I, you know, see the crowd and that build up before the game and all that, that's when it'll sort of start hitting. Right now I'm alright. Just now everything was pretty normal. Nobody said much. Except I could see both my wife and my mother both. When I was leaving home, they both were emotional. I mean, I could, my wife more so. My mother was trying not to show anything to me, but I could see in her eyes were lamp. And Anjali obviously said that this is the last time you're leaving home. Not just
for a cricket match. For a cricket match.
for a cricket match. But not just this one, but even the last Ranji Trophy. I left from Mumbai, so that match also she was emotional, saying this is your last first class match for Mumbai. So she was emotional then. Last week when I left for Calcutta, that time also, you know, she was emotional. So in fact that time she followed me all the way to the airport. She had some work there, so she followed me all the way, and she said that I cried all the way. Arjun was playing somewhere and she had to go and meet him, so it was different. I mean, I think this is one time where the rest of the family is getting emotional and I'm still okay.
I think that will hit you sooner.
That might change, who knows. You know, if my father could be present even just for a fraction on the last day of my cricketing career, that would be the best ultimate present for me. So, you know, he's always been in my thoughts. And, I'm sure he would have been proud of
the whatever
I did, because, you know, not because I've played for so many years or whatever, but anything I did, he thought that was wonderful. So, you know, to get full marks from him on whatever I did was not that difficult. So I'm sure he would have been extremely, extremely delighted and extremely proud to witness all this. That's a void which will always stay in my life. It's a damage which is irreparable. So you can't do much about it. No, Ajit didn't say much about the last match and all that. Absolutely nothing. But generally discussing my batting, like we always do.
Yeah,
I've done that from the time I started holding a cricket bat. So, you know, so that continues, and I'm glad even before the last game of my life that happened. Not always we agreed on, you know, whatever was discussed, because, you know, it was discussion, and on few occasions we didn't agree. He felt that I should be approaching the game like this, and I'm telling, but you don't know what's going on in my mind, so how can you
tell me
that
what
I should approach the game this way? So, well, those kind of things, but you know, in the end, we both are trying to reach one destination, which is winning matches for India and performing well. It really doesn't matter if we have different avenues as long as we get to one destination.
Correct.
That was something which I knew, because I was, I can say, representing India, but also him, because he's
right.
lived his
life
through me and my cricket, because he used to play cricket and he sacrificed all that. So then his dream of wanting to be something in cricket was through my cricket, because he had stopped and spotted that spark in me. So that sacrifice is something which cannot be measured at all. And never once mentioned about anything. Yes, I can say that I have lived my dream. I think if I am born again, I would want to replicate exactly the same thing, whatever has happened in my life. Couldn't have asked for more. I think whatever has come my way, I just thank God for every little thing that has happened. I wouldn't swap for anything else. I wouldn't settle for anything else. I think this is perfect, and as a 11-year-old child, this is what I dreamt of. I mean, I never thought that I would end up playing for 24 years. But just to be part of Indian squad was something. I watched so many games on television before I started playing serious cricket. And I always felt that this is where I should be. This is what I want to do in life. And then to be able to play for 24 years and be part of a team and do something which people appreciate. I mean, it was a buy one, get one free offer, because whatever I did all those things because I loved doing those things. And along with me, people also loved those things. So it was, I see one.